So I'm going to talk a little bit about the Haptic Hand. It's a device which we did together, one of a few devices during my master's thesis. So I'm going to start off with the motivation. Probably you have seen this slide already before in the morning event where Edgar presented. So in traditional musical instruments, you have visual and auditory and then haptic feedback. But in most of the computer music interfaces, the haptic cue is missing. And as Edgar already told, haptic cue is is much faster than the visual cue, for example. And therefore, we consider it important for musical playing, right? So the question is, how do we implement active haptic feedback for digital instruments? And yeah, this question beschäftigt. Yeah, we thought about it, and yeah, this is one solution, which is probably not the best solution for musical playing. It's a robotic hand, which simulates haptic for grasping things and which brings force to your finger. But as you can imagine, it's very expensive and not very convenient. So this is another attempt from some French guys in the 80s, I think. It's also very heavy built and it's also very expensive. So it's also probably not the best solution. Though it was kind of used in for academic purposes. So our design. We started with the already known firefighter from Edgar Berda. It's a fader which everybody can buy. It's quite cheap. I think in the US it's like $60, is it right? Or $40? One fader? Okay, even cheaper, right. Okay. But the idea was to mount them vertically. Yeah? So Edgar's devices since now were only in on this horizontally, and we wanted a device which you can play also vertically. So we did a prototype using laser cut parts. Yeah, this is another device from a student of Edgar, which uses prostheses to give haptic feedback. I haven't used it myself. It's made by Joe Sandler. Yeah, but our device, the Haptic Hand, is based on the open source hardware and software from Edgar. And yeah, you can see the schematics, which are freely available. In this schematic, you can see two fire faders connected to an Arduino, plus a motor controller. And basically, you need some resistors. But the schematic is basically easy for everybody who can read an electrical schematic scheme. So yeah, this is the Arduino we use, I mentioned already. And this is the Arduino control program, or IDE, how you call it. And yeah, this is pretty much the control loop Edgar also talked about today. You have the connection via USB interface. the calculation of the force and the sound is done all on a computer, and the force is sent back to the Arduino, and which then triggers the motor via pulse width modulation. So, and the physical forces in the audio can be computed, as I said, on a laptop, but they also can be computed on a Raspberry Pi too, which works pretty good as well. So, yeah, we thought then, because we wanted a device which you can play with four fingers, how we can measure the distance, like, or how should the pads which we want to play be, how much should they be apart, yeah? So, yeah, what we did was a pretty simple thing. So we just took, like you see, hand drawings from different people. And yeah, we put them all together, and we looked at okay, how does it? Where's the similarity? And how should we put our faders in between apart? Yeah. So as you can see, the index finger, the middle finger, and the ring finger pretty much overlay from the participants of this study, but there's some differences in the pinky finger. How you call it? The pinky, yeah. Okay. And also the thumb goes a little bit apart, but we didn't want the instrument to be controlled with the thumb, so we decided we only use this four fingers to control the instrument. Yeah, that's pretty much what it says. Yeah, and these fingers naturally also move in the same axis. And yeah, from this information we gathered, we came up with this prototype, and yeah, as you can see, the Arduino board is underneath. Everything is packed in. You have only the USB coming out, and yeah, I'm going to show you a short demonstration. So this is a little bit close up. Unfortunately, we don't have the device here with us because it's still in the States, and it was a little bit too heavy to bring it with, or too uncomfortable. yeah, but we have a nice video demonstration here. Yeah, I wanted to mention also, this can be played with any model from Edgar, but our SynthA modeler. We used mainly Max for this device, and we did some models specifically for this device. And yeah, probably there's like only limited by your imagination, right? So you can play anything with it. Like we tried it with samples, and we also programmed physical models, and yeah, we also tried to emulate real instruments like piano keys, for example. I'm giving you a short video demonstration now. And as you can see with this model, it's like a percussive model, and it's intended to play snare rolls with one or more fingers. drum rolls. I have to say, the sound here is not so impressive. It's more about the haptic feeling, which you can see here. Yeah, so pretty much to sum it up, yeah, you can see the example video source online. The idea pretty much is that anybody can build their own devices out of this open source components. So, for example, we put the LaserCut templates online, and of course, the software is open source from Edgar, and all the parts are freely available. Not free, but are available anywhere. You can buy them, and yeah, everybody is can build their own devices out of this. So, just your imagination you need. Thank you.